Penguin Random House Audio presents Old Time Radio's Greatest Shows, Volume 35, featuring Eddie Rochester Anderson, Sidney Greenstreet, Jimmy Stewart, and many more. Edited by Carl Amari.
The Adventures of Sam Spade, Detective. Brought to you by Wild Root Cream Oil Hair Tonic, the non-alcoholic hair tonic that contains lanolin. Wild Root Cream Oil, again and again, the choice of men who put good grooming first.
Sam Spade Detective Agency.
Hello, sweetheart. It's only me.
Oh, Sam. Why so modest?
Women, Effie. Age cannot weather nor custom stale their infinite variety.
Huh?
Against their incalculable wiles, mere man is a leaf in the wind.
Oh, Sam, do you really... Oh. Who was she and how windy was it?
Cyclonic, Effie. We had to close every window in the house.
But I...
If you will just contain your natural feminine curiosity for a few moments, I'll be right down to dictate my report on the bow window caper.
Dashiell Hammett, America's leading detective fiction writer and creator of Sam Spade, the hard-boiled private eye, and William Spear, radio's outstanding producer-director of mystery and crime drama, join their talents to make your hair stand on end with the adventures of Sam Spade. Presented by the makers of Wild Root Cream Oil for the hair. To every man who says, I don't use a hair tonic or I don't believe in a hair tonic, I say this. Decide for yourself. But don't decide until you've tried Wild Root Cream Oil, the entirely different hair tonic. There's not a drop of alcohol in Wild Root Cream Oil, and it contains soothing lanolin. What's more, it grooms your hair the right way, neatly and naturally. So get the big economy-sized bottle and the handy new tube at your drug or toilet goods counter. Wild Root Cream Oil Hair Tonic. Again and again, the choice of men who put good grooming first. And now, with Howard Duff starring as Spade, Wild Root brings to the air the greatest private detective of them all in The Adventures of Sam Spade.
Sam, what's a bow window?
Hmm?
A bow window.
A bow window is a bay window that you look into instead of out of.
Look into instead of out. Oh. Oh, Sam.
Get your book, Panther Girl, and slink on in.
Well, what was she trying to see through the bow window?
Hmm?
I mean, whose house was it?
Her own.
But if it was her own house, then why would she...
It just goes to show you, darling, what some women will stoop to.
It does?
Mm-hmm. It was a low window.
Oh. Well, whenever you're ready, Sam.
Date, November
10th.
Ninth. Correct. 1947. To Dr. Helmut Ries.
I was right for once.
Yeah. From Samuel Spade, license number 137596. Subject, the bow window caper. Dear Dr. Ries, I know that this report will not make pleasant reading for you, but you paid for it, so here it is. As far as I was concerned, it all started on Thursday morning when you called at my office. From your story, I gathered it had been going on for some time.
You will say these are merely the actions of a jealous woman, Mr. Spade. But I assure you there's more to it than that. It must be a carefully thought-out plan to ruin my career, my whole life.
In what way, Dr. Ries?
She spies on my private consultations. Insults my women patients. I can no longer even keep a nurse for more than a week at a time. Scenes, hysterics, she... outbursts of violence. I cannot continue my work under such conditions.
Well, why don't you give her a divorce?
Why, no. This is not her desire. If it were, it would be simple. No, she wants to bring me to ruin. She wants to see me on my knees in front of the public.
Why?
That is what I want to find out. Why?
Doctor, I think you ought to take this case to a head doctor.
I have consulted a psychiatrist. He examined her. She's perfectly competent mentally. So you see, there is here already some mystery. For which one comes to a detective?
How long has this been going on, Dr. Reese?
Since 3 months only. But in this time, she has reduced me to utter desolation.
Dr. Reese was a very good divorce lawyer right down the hall from my office.
No. I discussed the matter of a divorce with her a few days back. This was her answer. You see, a receipt for the purchase of a gun. And this note in her handwriting.
I hope you will not force me to use this. Esther.
Yes.
What do you think she has in mind? Murder or suicide?
She refused to discuss it. But one thing I have noticed. Since she has bought this gun, a new development, a strange man watches my house. Several times I have caught him following me.
Well, she might have hired a detective to check on whether you visit a lawyer.
Perhaps it is very simple, but it is all too strange to be harmless.
I half-heartedly agreed that it might be Dr. Reese, and when your check for $100 didn't bounce, I went to work wholeheartedly. I reached your house on Pacific Avenue just as the streetlights were going on. It's a quiet neighborhood, so I could hear it before I got close enough to read the number on the door.
Get out! Get out of this house! Get out!
They seemed to be slugging their way toward the back of the house, so I decided to risk an entrance. I found the doorbell, and I was about to punch it when I caught sight of your mystery man. He was crouched in a clump of shrubbery that grew under the bow window at the corner of the house. He was still there with his eyes glued to the window when I walked up behind him.
Hey, let go of me. Let go.
Come on. You're going inside.
Listen, I'm not just a snooper. I'm only...
I didn't say you were. I'm just inviting you inside for a better look.
Now, I'm warning you, if you don't let go of me, I'm...
Stop squirming, will you? Go! No! The kick he landed on me wasn't according to the Wrestling Association's rules, but I let him get away with it, mainly because I couldn't move for 3 or 4 minutes, and by that time he disappeared down the street. When I recovered my faculties and staggered back to the door, I didn't bother ringing the bell. I just walked in. The hen fight was still going on somewhere in the upper reaches of the house. Then a door burst open on the upper landing, and a girl in a nurse's uniform ran down the stairs toward me, pursued by a pale little woman with a pinched face who was brandishing a pair of brass fire tongs. You brushed past me, Dr. Reese, and headed off the pursuer.
Esther, stop it! Stop it at once! Have you gone crazy? Give me those fire tongs. Give them to me.
What's the matter, Helmut? Afraid I'll mar your light of love's beauty?
What started this?
I caught her creeping about the kitchen.
Ridiculous.
She's going to poison my food.
I explained to you, Mrs. Reese. The doctor
said... Oh, don't bother explaining, Miss Roberts. These morbid fancies of hers.
Don't think I don't know what goes on in that office. That office where I'm not allowed anymore.
That's only because you make the patient so nervous, Esther.
I know what goes on. You and those women.
That will do, Esther. Go to your room.
Very well. But I won't have that woman in this house another day, Helmuth. Is that understood?
Go to your room, Esther.
I'm going. But remember what I said. I've warned you both.
I can't.
There, Miss Roberts. Now don't. There.
I can't. Then anymore, Doctor. I tell you, it's making me a nervous wreck. I just...
Dr. Reese.
Huh? Oh, Mr. Spade. You saw, you heard?
Yeah.
Come into my office. We'll talk.
I think we'd better.
Doctor, there's still one more patient waiting to see you, Doctor.
Well, have her wait a little longer. Yeah. This way, Mr. Spade.
Well, the doctor will see you just as soon as he possibly can. Have you been feeling any better, Mrs.
Campbell? Sit down, Mr.
Spade. Thanks, but I can say what I have to say standing. Your wife's a very tragic woman, Doctor. I wish I could help her. I wish I could help you, too, but I can't.
You heard her threat against Miss Robbins. Was that a joke?
There's nothing funny about jealousy.
But there is this man who watches the house. The gun she bought.
I collared him outside just now.
Oh, well, did you get him to talk?
No, but I wouldn't worry about him if I were you. And about that gun. The Constitution says every citizen shall have the right to bear arms. Even Parnell Thomas can't do it.
Mr. Spade, I've not yet told you all. If I...
Oh, Doctor, I'm sorry to interrupt, but this patient, she's been waiting for more than an hour.
Well, who is she?
Mrs. Cavanaugh.
Cavanaugh, who? Well, has she been here before?
Of course, last week. Here's her card.
Oh, yes. I'd better get it over. Send her in.
Yes, Doctor. And Doctor, I'm resigning. I'll finish the day, of course, and then I'm through. I'm sorry.
Yes, well. Very well, Miss Robbins.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.